gyms. Here's where we are today, 24th of January, 2008. The girls should be set up right there. Hey, Mary. Everybody wave. And you see, we got surfboards up there. We got skate boards. We got parrots. Shuts off. Right?
What time do you tell a girl to be here?
7-ish.
You told them to.
Okay, bring it. And here comes Jolie. Come on. Come on. She's our first customer of the night.
How's it going?
Jolie lives right here in Washington, D.C.
Yep. About 20 minutes away. Actually, 40 with all the construction going on. So. I'm here. I wouldn't miss this for the world.
That's right.
It's AR.
Ah, there we go. Gotta open the shutter. Okay.
Hey, open the shutter.
We got people from Pittsburgh here. No, they cannot eat. Ah, what do you got here? Okay, now you're all big girls.
Not that big.
And if you're hungry, there's food back there. And if you're,
yeah, I'm gonna grab some.
Yeah. Oh yeah, no, we're pretty much.
So, we'd like for you both to state your name for the record, no pun intended.
Mary Sagar Miranda.
Yeah. Frank Miranda.
And what are we doing here this evening?
We're here to enjoy you guys. The privilege of Antigone Rise.
Thank you.
See, they always make us state our names before, whenever we do it, like, they put the camera on.
And what is your name?
They go, state your name and what you play.
State your name, what you play.
I'm Cathy Anderson and I play the lead guitar.
You play lead guitar. And what's your name?
My name is Kristen Lee Henderson.
Kristen Lee Henderson. And your name?
My name is Cassidy Cassidy.
Okay. Cassidy Cassidy. I have a question for you, Cassidy. Did you get my email that where I requested that you wear your Catholic schoolgirl outfit?
No.
Okay, damn it.
Where did you send that?
Well, thank you for your.
I sent it to Kristen. She
I
obviously.
Did get that. I didn't order that.
For us and for your friends and your family.
Things like this make me nervous. I get on stage and it's so easy, you know? There's a mic and there's like lights and I can sort of do, I can like disappear into the show, but this is like,
disappear, honey, disappear.
I mean, I'm gonna disappear, it's fine.
Is it okay for us to sing along?
Of course.
Please.
It's so great. Afraid. Don't let
you
my,
guys
never said
don't let
that.
My social awkwardness deter you. No, not at all. This is wonderful. This next song is called Michael.
Can you tell us what the song's about?
Michael, yeah. This is a song that is about my friend who I went to grade school with. And we went to the prom together and he taught me how to drive. When I was still underage, and I almost crashed his car into the back of my high school because I was hitting the gas when I thought I was hitting the brake.
Very nice.
We went to the prom together, and he was a great friend, and he was killed in a car accident about 15 years ago now. So this is a song about my friend Michael. Thank you. so invincible.
So we have a new album coming out this year, I think. And
everybody pray.
Yeah, pray to the rock gods. But we wrote it last year, and we recorded it last year, and we've been playing the songs at the shows, so a lot of people that come out to the shows have heard the song. And you can now, at our live shows, get recordings. We're recording all the live shows and selling them right there. So this next song is on the upcoming album. And it's about going back to maybe your youth or your heyday when you were hanging out with your friends and didn't have a lot of responsibilities and just sort of longing for to cut loose. Sounds how we were.
Rolling the back street, honey, have a good time.
I know that it is. That one. I know that it is. I felt you. I felt you back there.
But anyway, whatever.
We love it.
That was
kind of blurry.
So. Okay.
I knew I liked you, Gary.
Yeah. So, this next song is one that we wrote a few years back, and it's about really, well, I mean, you wrote it, but I always feel like it's one of those songs that Cassidy wrote that, you know, when you wrote it, it had great meaning.
Yeah.
But in retrospect now, it feels more like it's about our friend Giles.
Yeah.
It's a weird thing about this song.
Yeah.
I mean, we keep talking about people who passed away young, but a friend of ours passed away in a really sort of crazy accident that you wouldn't even believe if I told you, something that just no one could ever see coming and really senseless, and he used to come to our house and he used to record. He used to teach us how to use our recording equipment, and he was this really sort of moppy haired, almost like Shaggy from Scooby-Doo, just like really good natured, and like he'd come over, and at the time we were writing Firefly, I wrote Firefly, we wanted to record it, and he was the first person to ever record this song for us on our little home recording studio, and every time we sing it now, we sing it for Giles. It's about, but really, it's about going back home after maybe trying to find yourself again. You know, maybe after being gone for a really long time and trying to find that small essence of yourself that maybe you've lost, and thinking that you're gonna maybe find it back with your people and your family and find it in your roots. It's called Firefly. Yeah. He was looking for food. He was looking for his youth. But he was smiling for the was a man inside the room. He was talking in the long term upon his first rate avenue. Yeah, it was all with something missing, and it was hard to tell the truth. He says, all of it's part of me. It's facing me toward the north. Firefly, firefly, firefly. Step up to the counter, set a payment for your sin, for your sin. Says, all of it's killing me. My heart is pulled toward the north. Firefly, fire. Firefly.
Thank you, George.
Yes, ma'am.
George, ladies and gentlemen.
Hey, George! Woo!
Sound engineer extraordinaire.
George, we give you George.
So when he doesn't have a soundboard in front of him, he carries water.
Yeah, for those of you that come to see our shows, George is the man responsible for the amazing sound, the perfect blend. Coming. I said, all right, well, you don't know if there is, but
when we don't,
anyway,
when he doesn't have
there'll be, still
turn,
be shrimp.
He's not responsible for the sound, which depends on the water.
Yeah, that's right.
Sound.
Lubrication.
Can I buy Georgie a drink?
Yeah.
I'm good.
All right. Yeah, Georgie doesn't drink.
Oh.
Cheap,
none of us.
Can I buy Georgie water?
Yeah.
You can. You can buy Georgie water.
This song's from the ground up.
It's off of the Humana album.
This is a song that I wrote and the Cassidy. A lot of times the way we write, it depends, and so it's different, but it always helps when we do it together.
Yeah.
It always works.
I like it.
This was a song that I sort of wrote, and it was never quite done. But sometimes after you've written a song, you're just in your own way, and there's nothing you can do. Because it's only going to go to this one place, and you're only going to keep hearing one thing.
Right.
So, I played it for Cass, and she really liked it, and then she really fixed it. I put the word trajectory in it.
Yeah.
And they made such fun of me. They were like, are you going to sing that word?
I still, every time we get to that word, when we were running it, I'm like,
trajectory.
Yeah.
So, yeah.
She's a very smart lady.
Sometimes, like, I'll write a song, and then Cass will come in and tweak, and then Cassidy will write a song, I'll come in and tweak, or Cass and I will write a song, and Kathy will fix it.
Yeah.
You know, sort of fix each other's messes. Help the other one get out of their own way. The song's called Happy Home. This is our tribute to Crosby, Stills,
and Nash.
This was a request.
Mary wanted this one.
This is a song about my miserable relationship that I was in at the time. And I very ironically called it Happy Home.
Yeah. I sing it to my cats every morning.
To my cats. Right, it all depends on what it means to you, right?
I know.
Yeah. It's the best thing to do. It's best not to tell people what,
what they mean. I know. But
it was bad.
All right.
1, 2, 3, 4.
Says it all. Yeah.
course I knew I shouldn't love you. Of course I knew.
My mother always used to say to me when I would write songs and poetry, she'd be like, "You're so sad. They're so depressing."
Right. And then they blame themselves. They're like, yeah. "What did I do wrong?"
Yeah. I'm like, "Mom, I write sad songs so I don't have to be sad every day in my life. I'm happy, but I can write it down and then get rid of it." You know? She's like, "No."
Oh, okay. So we're fine.
Yeah. You're not depressed. Not today. Thanks for asking. The reason I bring it up is because this one's, you know, it's about as happy as it gets. That last one is.
Rescue, that's my cat.
Yeah.
Hope you like that one. That's the happy song.
Yeah, that's the happy song.
What happy was in it? What else do you want from us?
This next song actually was inspired by not my relationship, somebody else's. I had a friend who was. Just, you know, I'm like the friend that is the one that'll tell you, like, you know, you're not happy or get out of your relationship. I'm the one. Like, you don't want to have dinner with me if you're not doing well. So I'm going to tell you. Like, everybody else will, like, ignore. I'm like, finger right on it. That's just what I'm like. And my friends know it. I have one that's avoiding me right now, actually. She knows I got a message for her. So that's what this is about. This is about one of my best friends, if not my best in the whole world, really, who was just in a bad thing. And this is her. This is her singing. This is absolutely her saying this to her. We wrote this together in Nashville. This song is called Out of My Way. This is for the new record.
Still can't feel it. Out of my way.
sick of tuning. Me too.
Me too. But there's nothing worse than jumping into a song with a string attitude.
Oh, yeah.
And we really do want to thank Frank and Mary for being so supportive.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Thank you. To Frank and Mary.
Cheers.
What anniversary is it, Frank?
And happy anniversary.
Second. I went through that already.
Tomorrow night we're going to be at the Birchmere in Alexandria.
Correct.
Yeah. Vanessa will be there.
Vanessa!
She'll be harmonizing with you,
plus
chicks.
You all should check out the website, Antigone Rising. They have all the list of upcoming concerts.
Yeah.
Because it's...
You should see the full band, too. The other two are pretty terrific.
You're great.
Yeah, the other two are pretty terrific, too.
Yeah.
You're your sisters, right?
Who's the best?
You're the best.
Who's the best? Who's your favorite, lady? Who's your favorite? Pick a favorite.
My favorite?
Choose point to Cathy. I'm only kidding. I'm only kidding.
Yeah, that's not fair. Yeah,
don't answer that.
She always wants to know who the pretty one is.
She makes people do that.
She does.
She'll be like, come on, who's your favorite?
What is it that I say? I say, whose lunchbox would you buy?
Yeah.
That's what I say that, but then I say,
oh, no, you're all the pretty ones.
That's right.
We're
right.
All the pretty ones.
That's what your mom says.
Yeah.
Right.
Your concerts are so energetic, and that's why we have gone to,
you never get tired of women in the
audience. Yeah, exactly.
Nice, lady.
All right, this is a song called Breeze, and this is a positive one. This is saying thank you to people that, Kathy's not ready. This is basically saying thank you to somebody who's helped you along the way.
Right. All right, thanks.
Thanks?
Thanks.
Afraid, the best time do your fighting. You're the reason.
us, but
what's next? We're doing.
We're about done. This next song was also on the front of the Ground Up record, which was the Starbucks record that Frank and Mary discovered. Which is nice.
Yeah.
And it's a song that we co-wrote with Rob Thomas from Matchbox 20. And it was the first single off the record. Mm. We shoot a video to it. It was fun. And it's hardly too much makeup on. And we were wearing too much makeup in the video.
But it was worth getting up at 4 a.m.
It was great.
The one you did on Good Morning America?
Yes. The Today Show.
The Today Show.
Yeah. Was Good Morning America?
It's the same thing.
Exactly.
Yeah, Matt Lauer.
Yeah. Matt Lauer. We met Katie Couric at our interview.
Yeah.
You're very good.
She's very small.
That was good. That was a good performance. Leno was scary. That one was better. Leno, we were like,
and he's very tall.
I was so frenetic. I could see it. I was like, my eyes were like silver dollar. I was so scared.
How about Emerald?
Emerald was fun too.
Very cool.
Emerald was a nice person.
My mother watches Emerald, and I talk about you guys.
So many people have seen us on that. You'd be surprised how many people come up and say Emerald and anything else.
So. Well, Emerald, and replay it like 50,000 times. Yeah. So it's like I was in the gym one time jogging, and there's like 50 TVs across, and every other TV had Emerald on. I was like, oh, cool, Emerald, and I was like, oh, shh.
It happens to me in the gym on those feet.
But no one knows. You know, you're jogging at the gym.
Yeah.
People don't think, you know, they're not going to figure it out.
It's amazing.
Yeah, but then you think, is Emerald in here?
Right, well, who's next to me?
Wait a minute.
It happens more than
ever. Brad Pitt?
Is that Brad Pitt?
What are you talking about?
Speaking of Brad Pitt, we did a record out in L.A. We recorded out in L.A. and we lived out there for like 4 months. And we used to go to this gym. We had a trainer that would train us.
Oh, yeah.
And every other day, every other morning, she would have two of us. And then the next morning, she'd have the other two. And we'd rotate back and forth. Where was the fifth one?
Not bad. Dina, was she?
Asleep?
No, Stanley went with me.
And not every time. I think Stanley went alone sometimes. No, anyway, so with this trainer, this is irrelevant. So anyway, this trainer would train us every morning. And so we'd go to this gym every morning, and our trainer trained us, and there was another trainer there who every morning was training a very famous actress, Rosanna Arquette.
I mean, come on.
So we would see her every morning.
You guys are famous.
Wait, let me finish that.
No, wow. We'd see her every morning.
We're about to sort of slag her a little. I am. She'd never say hello to us. Right? After you see somebody like,
nobody says hello to you in LA.
But then, okay, this is weird though. She would see like us every morning and then the other two every other morning, right? Then we ran into her one night at a restaurant and we were all together.
We kept
now, if you
ran
into people you saw every morning in a gym, wouldn't you be like, hi, this is so weird. Hi, finally, hello. She never did say hello.
We kept running into her everywhere, and we were like,
she used to wear a tie-dye jog suit that was so ugly. Every day. I know. We never said hello. We're so
we were invisible.
I know. She did. She was in there. Yeah. She went, oh,
that damn Antigone rises every morning in the gym.
She's never said hello. But look, you know.
Yeah, but I'm shy. She's not. After the 80th time, I thought she would have said hello.
What's this song that we're doing?
So this is talking about Rosanna Arquette.
No, it's not. Rosanna. There's so many songs about her. Rosanna's about her. In Your Eyes by Peter Gabriel is about her.
And this
and
one.
This song.
And this song.
Well, no wonder she didn't say hi.
And, 1, 2, 3, 4.
Changing.
Jamie Gertz also worked out at that gym, and she was friendly.
She was friendly. All the Lifetime ladies.
As did, who's the one from The Biggest Loser?
Caroline Ray.
Oh, yeah, you would have loved this gym.
With some gym. Oh, yeah. That was some gym.
Who has a better bicep?
We were all just trying to not be fat.
Thank you.
It's impossible.
Even at your thinnest, you're fat.
I know. I was so skinny, and I was like, I'm obese. Hollywood will mess your head up. I'm in New York now. Much easier.
Oh, my God, you are.
What do you say?
He's like, on Sunset Strip, I'm Walter Hudson.
He's crazy.
He is crazy. That's George. I know. It's so upsetting. I'm trying to change the look of rock and roll.
Single-handed.
Hourglass.
You're doing it, girl.
Is that what you've been dragging me along on this ride?
Finally!
I can't.
We've suspected
it.
All along.
I like to eat. You forgot to CC me on that email. Sorry about that.
There was no email, I don't think. All
right, what's next? Play me a song. We wrote this song in our first apartment, this little tiny little one-bedroom apartment. We had linoleum all through the apartment, even in like the living room. And it was $400 a month, and we split it, and that was like top. And we lived above a dry cleaner and a nearly new shop, but it was kind of like junk that people left on the side of the room.
Nearly new.
Yeah, that's what, like, in my town they used to call it nearly new. It was like used furniture and stuff, but there used to be like sinks and stuff.
Like lining right up to our front door, and there would be like
toothpaste.
It was a sink. It was a
Anyway, that was our life, and our moms were worried about us, to say the least.
They were mostly worried about the dry cleaner, that we lived above a dry cleaner.
Yeah.
Did you watch that Dateline about the dry cleaners?
Health insurance. They were worried that we didn't have health insurance. So this is, we wrote this, I was just snot crying on the couch one day, like really bad, and blubbering, and Kristen's like, hey, I want to write that with you.
I was like, oh no, you don't. Give me that guitar. I'm like, you're stuck. You need help.
Yeah, I was. All right, this song's called Broken.
I am a diamond and cannot be broken. Give it some time. If you could just be kind to me, 'cause I don't care. The life I waste is mine. It don't mean much in the grand scheme. I've given up and given everything. Give it away. gonna be grown. Die, I am alive, cannot be grown. You're a diamond too, I was cut from you. You're a diamond too, I was cut from you.
Heard about us through the press of Frank and Mary. We do have CDs available for sale, but we also have an email list, more importantly. So if you would like to keep up to date on all that's happening in the land of Antigone Rising, you can sign our email list.
We won't bombard you or sell it or anything.
We will
like that.
Sell it. We sell it on a regular basis. We spam you. We fish you. No. We just send out a newsletter saying what Cassidy's wearing.
Force me down, the points.
Now we just send updates, you know.
Yeah, let you know what
things of this nature. Yeah.
You should have seen the Halloween get up.
Oh,
I said
he liked
that.
It.
Oh, that was great.
I was a Catholic school girl, and it seems we enjoyed it.
Kathy choking all the time.
That was so funny. She was sick. Look at what happened to the show. I would really, for a minute, was like, snap out of it. I need a show to play. We're talking about you doing the hair, camera girl. We're talking about you choking on the hair.
Oh. We're looking right at you, and then I really thought you were going to.
I'm sure watching it must have been interesting.
There was a moment where I was like, oh my God, like this is bad.
She had a wig on, she
started
choking.
It just went. I really thought that was it for me.
This next song is a
show must go on.
A Bob Dylan song.
I did it though, I played. I don't know how I played, which is.
I know, I was impressed.
And the fact that I was playing, I was saying to myself, you might think this is bad, but you're still playing, so it can't be that bad. But then I tried tugging on Cassidy. I'm like, I have to take a break.
And she's like, what? What?
Like, how do you take a break in the middle of the whole thing?
I couldn't. I was scared. I was like, snap out of it.
Even when you were playing the keyboards, I thought you were going to do it again. Like, oh my God, she's going to have to do it again. She's going to have to swallow something else.
A big beard would come out of my face. It was awful.
We're going to do just a couple more songs, and we're going to say goodnight. Thank you so much.
She's sucking up.
I've seen love go by my door. It's never been this close before. It's never been so easy or so slow. I've been shooting in the dark too long. If something's not right, it's wrong. You're gonna make me lonesome when you go. Purple clover, queen as lace, crimson hair across your face. You can make me cry, but you don't know. I don't remember what I thinking of. You might be spoiling you too much love, honey. You're gonna make me lonesome when you go. But situations have ended sad. Relationships have all been bad. Might have been like Burlington Rambo, but there is no way I can compare all that scenes with this affair. You're gonna make me lonesome when you go. You're gonna make me wonder what I'm doing, staying far behind if I were you. You're gonna make me wonder what I'm saying. You're gonna make me give myself a good talking to. I will look for you in Honolulu, San Francisco, and Ashtabula. You're gonna have to leave me now, I know. But I will see you in the skies above, the tall grass, the ones I love. You're gonna make me lonesome when you go. You're gonna make me lonesome when you go. You're gonna make me lonesome.
Last song of the night.
Rosita.
Oh, yes. Nice. Sure. Well, thank you again, and thank you again for really for everything.
Thank you.
2008 is the year of Antigone. Mark my words.
Thank you for coming down.
That was our pleasure. So, thank you.
Thank you.
So fun.
Thank you.
Tomorrow night again, Birchmere, Alexandria, Virginia. Anybody feels like taking
it? Is the show sold out yet?
It's almost. It's getting there. So.
All right.
Yeah, but it's a really great room to see shows if you've never been.
We've
been.
Great.
Yeah,
and
great.
Did you bring any CDs tonight?
We did.
Yes,
we
all right. CDs,
yeah. Woo! Where are they?
Hi. True. By request.
Come on!
It was rain for a year, drop for drop and tear for tear, on the girl who wouldn't stand out in a crowd. She was born to the son of a minivan salesman on an early August morning under clouds.
Scream with envy, wishing they had
We have friends that want to sing with you. We have friends that want to sing with you.
Mary wants to sing with you.
Oh, who wants to sing? Mary
does.
Vanessa wants to sing with you. Vanessa wants to sing with you. She's running away.
My friend.
We have friends that want to sing with you.
How's your NHD project coming?
She's gonna feel like we're at a real concert.
Come on!